hello. Wow. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome to Broken Clay Ministry. This morning, I'm Prophetess Kay McCray of Broken Clay Ministry, Phoenix City, Alabama. And I just want to thank you for taking the time this morning to want to come in, come over, come into our room and listen to the word of the Lord. We believe by faith that all is well today, and we're so grateful and thankful to you, to the Lord, for you. And if you would, just maybe share it. Share the fact that Broken Clay Ministry that we are on, that we are releasing the word this morning in our morning service. So if you would do that, that would be great. Great. Now, if you're wondering how can you contact Broken Clay Ministry, you can do so by sending us an email at brokenclayministry777.org. That's our website. That's brokenclayministry777.org is our website. Or you can email us at brokenclayministry@gmail.com. Or to learn more about us, we have a platform on YouTube. If you go out on the Broken Clay Ministry, go to our home page, and if you would, subscribe, share, subscribe to this. You know, we're in that world of algorithms, and the more the better from that standpoint so that we can get the word out. Also, you can Google us and check us out on our podcast, on the Broken Clay Ministry podcast. So there are many platforms that you can find out about us. So we would just want to just invite you to come in and to share with us. Well, today, I am just so grateful that you have chosen to be with us, and at this time, I'm just elated. I'm excited about what the Lord is doing, not only in my life, but I pray he's doing a change in your life as well. So I celebrate that. I am in the spirit of celebration and the spirit of expectation as to what he's going to do today, what he's going to say today, how he's going to mix it all up today, but all is well. All is well. All is well. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, we have with us today none other than my husband, Minister Kenny McCray. And he's going to just come and share some golden nuggets. You know how he do. So he can release some golden nuggets today.
Yes. Welcome, 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 everyone. I know we've been gone for a week. You know, the birthday girl here, she had to, you know, I'm telling you, you got to get away. You know, everything is always well. You got to get away. You just have to go and just, man, we were just basking in the presence of God, man, even up in the mountains, up way up in North Georgia, man, and it was nice, you know, just to see water coming out the rocks and how, man, mountains that were so high, and man, and I was so chicken, I wasn't finna play with them. They were too far down there. I couldn't see the bottom, you know, but it's almost like our faith, you know, we have to trust God, because sometimes we can't see the bottom, we can't see the light, we can't see the end of a thing. But he sees and knows it all way before we even think about what's there. He's always there. Amen. Yeah. Amen. And I just wanted to come out and just, I wanted to thank all of our partners, man. Yeah, I mean, y'all are awesome. You're terrific. You know, I mean, you take your time, you take your talents, you even take your money, you're sowing into this ministry. Amen. And I thank you, and I believe that God is blessing you just even more as he's blessing us. It's a blessing to be a blessing, as the word says, but it's a blessing just to be able to bless somebody with something, and then God's still pouring into you. Yeah. Man, I tell you, you know, we're the over 60 gang now, and man, you know, and he's still pouring. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, man, you know, wow. You know, it's just truly amazing. Because I'm telling you, when you are a giver, you will get given to by him. Mm-hmm. And I mean, thou shaken together, man, shall men give into your bosom, man. I don't know. I think he'd be pulling it out of his bosom because, man, I tell you, it's just so it's tremendous, man. I mean, my God. I mean, it is awesome. So if you're not a partner, become one. You know, Prophetess, you mentioned all the site. You can go to our website, or you can go to our P.O. Box here in Phoenix City, Alabama, at 23-2336-868, Phoenix City, Alabama. That's P-H-E-N-I-X. Or you can go to our Cash App at $BrokenClay. Amen, amen. And once again, we're glad to be back. We're back again, and my God, let's see what God got to talk today about faith and the imagination. You know, I'm way back from the temptation days, saying, well, just my imagination running away with me. But can you imagine when the Holy Spirit starts to run away with you? Man, you know you're finna go somewhere great. Amen. You know it's going to be a good time. So we want to just welcome everyone. Welcome all. Thank all partners. Everyone that is giving into this ministry, man. And man, God bless you. We thank you. Yes. We honor you. Yes. And you know, and the word says that in everything, give thanks. So every little bit, man, you ain't got to do that. 100 or 1,000 or 10,000, man. Hey, look, I'm from the old church. If you drop a dollar, man, guess what?
Thank you.
Man, thank you. I'm saying, he said in everything, give thanks. You know, even the kids, you know, we used to go around and drop them little dimes and pennies and nickels in there. You know, we didn't understand it. But we was actually sowing into the kingdom of God and didn't even know. You know what I'm saying? Amen. So you become a sower and a tither. Even in your own church, you need to sow there. You need to tithe there, man. And if you don't, then, you know, what are you believing in? That man and woman of God is working there on your behalf. So, you know, if they are not the right one, go somewhere else. But you do need to sow. You need to sow because you got sowing, you can't reap. You know, because you reap what you sow. Amen. All right, so let's get it going here. I'm going to slide back in my category B today. But I did have a nugget for you, though. I'm saying, I know you just wanted to land about, like, okay, what are you going to say? Let me just say this. I'm just going to shoot you this nugget about storms, okay? Because I know we got a lot of stuff going on today, and God gave me this message back. He gave me this word back on, let's see here, September the 2nd. And he said, God sends storms, and he stops storms. But it's still up to you to choose to serve him, and your faith level will determine. Yeah. Let me say that again. Wow. I mean, he just sent me to this one. He said, God sends storms and he stops storms. But it's still up to you to choose to serve him. And your faith level will determine the outcome. My God. He said, without faith, it's impossible to please him. So let's come on up. That's my little nugget for you this morning. God bless you. I thank you. And man, let's get it.
Hallelujah. Praise God. What a nugget. Come on up, church. That's what he's saying. Hallelujah. So let's just come together corporately, you and your home and your car or wherever you may be, and let's go to the Lord. Let's just have a moment of prayer to give him and to give him the opportunity and to allow him to come into your heart today, into your home, into your temple, into you where you are. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we just thank you today. We thank you for life and health and strength. We thank you for all that you have done, is doing, and will continue to do in our lives. And we glorify you and we magnify you. Hallelujah. Jesus, we just thank you for fulfilling the assignment of Father, where you came and you took all the sins of the world on you at Calvary. You died, but yet you rose from the grave through the dunamis power of the Holy Spirit that was released. It is through the power of the Holy Spirit that we say you're welcome, 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 Holy Spirit. You're welcome. We invite you in and we ask that you continue to operate in our lives and to do things in our lives that only you can do in our mind. Father God, we just thank you today. We ask for the waters of the Holy Spirit to wash over us from the top of our heads to the sole of our feet. We ask you to do according to your desires today, and I move myself out of the way, Kay out of the way, and I ask you, Holy Spirit, to do what you want to do, how you want to do. I will release this word, but I ask that you do it. Use me as the container, as that vessel to release your word to your people today. And let there be life and godliness that flow out of it, that change all things. We thank you today, and we glorify and magnify you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and the church says, amen. Amen and amen. Praise God. Praise God today. Hallelujah. The last time that we were together was we released a word, and the word was faith to live in the new place. If you can, if you would, just revisit that and go back. That was in September. And listen to that word, faith to live in the new place. Because I think we all can agree that we are totally in a new place. We're in a new land. In a new land. We're in another place in time. I think that was Michael Stamplin that sang that song that flows in the spirit so well. We are in another place, in a new place, in time. So today, the message that I have for you today, and the title of it is when faith and imagination collide. When faith and imagination collide. So it can be three components that we're going to talk about. We're going to pull it apart. And then we're going to put it back together again. Faith, imagination, and collides. That's faith, imagination, and collides. We are all living in a new world, in a new place that we've never been before. We're dealing with, on a global standpoint, of global reset. All around the world, things are resetting. All around the world, you hear basically the same thing as it relates to the virus that is going on. In this global reset that is going on around the world, we're also hearing fear. We're hearing fear that is going on. Fear, fear, fear. But faith is what's going to propel us to move out of those places of fear that wants to come and isolate you or put you in a place that you can't move, that you're immobile. So in this global reset, we have to begin to move into a place in the spirit of Almighty God that will cause us to just say, you know what? CNN, MSNBC, Fox, whatever news channel you may listen to, there comes a time that you have to turn that stuff really off. Because if you constantly feed yourself fear, then you will constantly be in a place of fearing. You will become what you feed yourself in this hour, in this global reset. When I talk about reset and when I think about reset, I have my cell phone here, and most everybody have cell phones. Even little children have cell phones these days. But it comes a time that something happened in that cell phone. And that cell phone needs to do what? An update. When we deal with updates, you will get a notification that we need to do this. Okay, we'll give you a chance to set the time that you can say tomorrow morning at 3:30 a.m. or whatever you want to do. Or you can say now. Or you can reset now. But what happened in the process of resetting is that you have to turn the system off. Matter of fact, as it resets, update, recalibrate, realign, readjust, reestablish, it shuts its own system down. Your phone goes off. While it's doing behind the scene all the things that we as users of phone don't understand, the technical, the inside, the intricate part of rebooting, realigning, readjusting, recalibrating, in this global reset. But we got to bring it on to the house, in your house, which dwells the Holy Spirit. There's a resetting, rebooting, realignment that is taking place in your life now. You may not understand it, but it's tapping into the Spirit of Almighty God that will take us into a place that we've never been before. Oh, we're talking today about when faith and imagination collides in this process. Now, we remember we said we're going to break it down from three components: faith, imagination, and collides. So, let's go to faith. If you would, go in your Bibles and look at Hebrew 11 and 1. Hebrew 11 and 1, according to the King James, says, "Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen." According to Hebrew 11 and 3, it says, "It is by faith that we understand that the universe was created by God's word, so that what can be seen was made out of what cannot be seen." We're talking about faith, but in talking about faith, we are talking about the unseen realm. Faith, faith. Now faith is the substance. The substance of a matter is the heart of the matter, is the core of the matter. Faith is the substance. Faith is the core. Faith is, for example, if we were making a cake today, I can have the eggs, the butter, I can have the flavor, I can have the sugar, I can have all of those components, but if I don't have the main substance of the cake, which is the flour, I will not produce income of the end result of a cake. So faith is the main core, the component of the manifestation that ties us to the Word of God. Faith in the Word of God. Faith in God. Faith to believe. Faith by faith, by faith, by this component. We're talking about when faith and imagination collides, but faith, faith. Now, as we progress forward in faith, faith goes from glory to glory. You go up glory to glory. And I want you to just imagine with me this morning this grand house. And in this grand house is this magnificent spiral staircase that goes up. All spiral staircases do not go in a circle, although we're seeing spiral. But just imagine this grand staircase. Grand. As the staircase, we're looking at it, but we're seeing it in the spirit. The staircase is grand because the house is so massive. The bigger the house, the bigger the staircase will have to be installed. So the staircase in this house is elevating and going up. Now, we go from glory to glory, and I'm comparing it to this staircase, this grand staircase. So as it goes up, we're going from glory to glory. It goes up. Also, with a spiral staircase, you can go up, or a staircase itself, you can go up, but you can also come down. Also, with this grand staircase, there's when you walk up and you may do 17 or 18 steps, and then there's this place called a landing. A landing is a place where you rest. It's a place that you can stop. You can stop. Don't go any further. This is it. This is it. This is my level of faith. I'm not doing it. I'm good. I'm good right here. Or you can continue to progressively move up to the next 17, 18 steps before there's another landing. But everything in the kingdom of God, according to our faith, it goes from glory to glory. It goes in a progression. It goes in an upward momentum. And you can make a decision where you are in your faith. Are you at the faith to keep moving up? Are you at the faith to come down? Are you at the place with faith that your faith is resting because I'm just on this landing pad? I've stopped at this point right now. But faith is the substance of things hoped for. You're moving toward your hope. You're moving in the word of God that has told you, according to reading the word, that you are an overcomer, that you can. You can win. You are a winner in the word, in Christ Jesus, through the word. I believe by faith. We have to believe by faith, according to 2 Corinthians 4 and 13 of the Amplified Version. And it read, yet we have the same faith, spirit of faith, yet we have the same spirit of faith as he had who wrote in scriptures, I believed, therefore I spoke. We also believe, therefore we also speak. Okay, so in faith that we believing in the word, we believing in the spirit of faith. What the spirit of faith deals with is one of the nine spirits, the gifts of the spirit, faith. And under that gift of faith, it is the supernatural ability to believe God without human doubt, unbelief, or reasoning. I'm going to read that again for you. When we're talking about the spirit of faith, it's a gift. It's one of the nine gifts of the spirit. And it is a supernatural ability to believe God without human doubt, unbelief, or reasoning. You just believe the word of God. You take it to your soul. You take it into your heart. You take it and you believe. You believe. You believe the word and you believe by faith. We come into faith because we believe by faith. We believe that it is true. We believe that God is the creator of all things. We believe that God is in heaven. We believe that Jesus is sitting at the right hand of the Father, making intercession for you, for me. We believe the word because the word is truth. Also, when it comes to faith is like building a house, right? When we build the house, the most important components of building a house, that all of it is important, but the foundation is the main thing. When you lay concrete costs so much money. It's very expensive. It's easier in construction to lay the foundation for a house that has stories, two stories, three thirds, however many stories in it, as opposed to lay the foundation that is a ranch that sprawl out. As it sprawl out, the more concrete we lay in width, the more the house costs from that standpoint because of the cost of the foundation. Hear me in the spirit. The cost of your foundation would be that of your faith. Your faith is the foundation. Your faith in the word is your foundation. Your faith in the word frames your life to move into a place when faith and imagination collide. You have to have faith. Faith to move mountains. Faith to turn those no's into a yes. Faith to believe that you can succeed. Faith to believe that your marriage will work. Your marriage is under the covenant of Almighty God. Faith to believe that things are possible that seems impossible to you. That is the foundation. The foundation in building your house as it relates to faith. 1 Corinthians 2 and 9 says, but as it is written, eyes have not seen nor ears heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for them that love him. See, we're talking about eyes of a vision, hearts to receive, and prepared, that deals with preparation. This is a process Faith is a process of preparation. Faith is a process of preparation. We have to operate in faith. We have to operate and know that we're connected to Almighty God. We have to operate to see the vision. See, sight, sight. The future in God and the word that we believe. Today we're talking about when faith and imagination collides. According to the Strong Concordance, when we look at the word imagination, that's the second part of what we're talking about today, imagination. Well, Strong Concordance, according to the Hebrew, takes the word imagination and it breaks it down to mean to plan, to consider, to plot, to purpose, and to think. Again, imagination. To plan, to consider, to plot, to purpose, and to think. Okay, that's going to enclose and encompass a lot as we continue to move forward. Imagination. Imagination, like anything, can be used for good or for evil, correct? I think you will agree with that. But we're talking about the Word of God. But we're also talking about how we have to look at where we are, to see where we are, to see the condition of our soul in this process of imagination. Imagination comes from the heart as it relates to the purpose of your heart. See, man look at the outside, but God looks at what? The heart, the heart. He sees your heart. He knows the inner workings of your heart. He knows everything about you. Imagination is tied to the condition of your soul, the soul being of the components of your mind, that's your thoughts, what you think, your will, that's your decisions that you make based on what you think, or your emotions as it relates to how I feel in that instance of things. So we're talking about the imagination, but we're also talking about looking at it from a standpoint of what can be considered in your imagination of evil. We're looking at it from the standpoint of what you consider in your imagination that lines up with the Almighty God that is of good. Because we've given a will. The Lord gave us a will. And in that will, he gave you the will to decide which way you want to go. Excuse me one second. It gives you the will. Hallelujah. See, when the soul is healthy, the realm of imagination is rooted and grounded in the Word of God. Because when our soul, that's our mind, our will, and our emotions, lines up with the Word of God, and we put ourselves under the subjection of the Word that will cause us to line up with the Word, then we start saying the Word. We start meditating on the Word. We start releasing the Word. We start living in the Word. I can quote scriptures. You can quote scriptures from Genesis to Revelation, but if those scriptures and those principles are not applicable in your life, that you can show that there is a manifestation that shows up in your life where others can not only see, but they can also know that you're walking in the fullness of the Word of God, then it's just a principle, but a principle is a principle. The kingdom of darkness use principles. They do. They contaminate the word, or they also take it and they counterfeit the word. But a principle is a principle. A law is a law. The law of gravity, what goes up, come down. When you jump out of the window on the 62nd floor, you're not going up, you're going down. That's a law. Law. There's laws in the kingdom. There's principles of the kingdom that make it applicable as we move forward, not only with our faith, but also in our imagination of where we are. Now, how does imagination affect reality? Do it affect reality? Imagination has much to do with reality. It shapes the way we see our reality and therefore affect our expectations, our hopes, our actions, and behavior. Your imagination is part of that construction that deals with faith that frames it. If in fact, your faith is not aligned to the word of God. What you are framing as it relates to imagination of your expectations, your hopes, your actions, and your behavior will be tied to something outside of the word as it relates to God is a good God. Good. He uses all things for his glory. But in the process of imagination, I am presenting to you lining up with the word of God as it relates to a good outcome, as it relates to love, as it relates to peace and joy. But imagination of the word of God as to who you are and who you was created to be today. This is what we're talking about when faith and imagination collides. So your condition of your soul is tied to everything. And if you listen to Broken Clay Ministry, this is what we teach on, the healing of the wounded soul. The soul is in every part of the facet of who you are, your soul. Your soul has to be healed. Your soul has to be, all those wounds in your soul has to be brought to a place of healing, of release, of forgiveness, let go, of knowing that God has already touched. The balm of Gilead has been applied and your world has changed. Your world has lined up in the healing process of being made whole. Ephesians 3:20 teaches, now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we can ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within you. That goes back to faith. It goes back to the power of the Holy Spirit. That goes back to when you see yourself in that grand staircase. Remember, the staircase is going up. Are you continuing to go up in the spirit? Are you continuing to go up in elevation of glory as it relates to your relationship with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit? Are you going up, up? This is what we're talking about this morning, to go up. You may get to that point on the staircase that is the landing. Remember that resting place? You may take it and say, Lord, I thank you. Let the landing be the place where you just thank God and celebrate for what he is doing in your life and how he has brought you to where you are. And you thank him for the promotion. You thank him for the process. You thank him for everything that he has done on that landing step. Regroup, reboot, realign, readjust, and let's go up. Let's go up, church. Let's move forward. Let's move forward in the kingdom of Almighty God, knowing that he has great things in store for you. His purpose, his plan for your life is good. He has good things in store for you. But the only way that any of us are going to move and accelerate in the fullness of the kingdom of Almighty God is that we believe by faith in the word of God. Apply the word, get revelation of the word, get understanding and all that, get some understanding of the knowledge of who God is so that we can continue to move in the word, the revelation of the word, the truth of the word, because when revelation comes, you can't put an old mindset back in an old wineskin. It bursts, it explodes, it expands you to the point that you can't do it like you used to do it. The objective is to become better today than you were yesterday. And that means that we have to take an assessment of our faith. We have to take an assessment of what we're seeing. We have to take an assessment of the imagination of Almighty God as we move forward and up that staircase. Up the glory, the glory, the glory, the glory that we're moving upward and onward and forward. We are trailing up, up, moving forward, going up. Hallelujah. Keep in mind as we continue to talk about imagination, the definition. It means to plan, to plot, to purpose, and to think. Okay? Hallelujah. I want to look at two parallels to present to you today. And one of the parallels, we're looking in the book of Genesis, but the one of the parallels is going to come from the Tower of Babel. That's found in Genesis 11 and verse 3 through 6. And I'm reading from the King James, and it read, and they said one to another, go to, let us make brick and burn them thoroughly. And they had brick for stone, and slime they had for mortar. And they said, go to, let us build us a city and a tower, whose top may reach unto the heaven. And let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower, which the children of men built it. And the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have all one language. And this they began to do, and now nothing will be restrained from them, which they have imagined to do. You see that? Okay. They have imagined to do. When you look at the Good News translation, it says that they will be able to do anything they want to. And then we look at the American Standard Version, and it says, and now nothing will be withheld from them which they purpose to do. Remember that word imagination? It means to purpose. That's where it is. So what is happening here as we pull it apart? The Tower of Babel, the children of men came together and they said, okay, let us build us a city and a tower. Let us make a name. Let us be not restrained. Let us have imagination to do. They were on the spirit of one accord. That's where we in the body of Christ have to get, with the unity of oneness. One Lord, one God, one baptism. But believe in the oneness of the power of corporate anointings, corporate apostolic release, and also from the standpoint of the spirit of oneness. They was in the spirit of oneness. They had the faith to believe. They was on one accord. They spoke the same thing. They said the same thing. They said the same thing. They said the same thing. In the body of Christ now, we hear so many things. But the thing of it is, there's a remnant that is coming forth that will say what God is saying. And then the church will begin to say the same thing. The same thing from a standpoint of reset global. Reset not only in the world, but also reset in the kingdom of Almighty God. When you look at the Tower of Babel and you see it from the perspective, it is being presented to us about as if God didn't know, because he knows all things. God is omniscient. He is omnipresent. He is all things. He's here and he's there. He is God. He is the great I am. So as it coming forward and being presented, that God came down to see. God see all things. He knows all things. He wrote it all down. It's already recorded as to what you would do. But the thing of it is showing you a principle. And that principle is dealing with oneness, the spirit of one accord. So they came together. They had the imagination that they can let us. Okay? Remember, when you go back and what happened in heaven, that is what Satan began to do. Satan said, Lucifer, when he was in the kingdom of God, when he was in heaven, and he started making his own coup of how he's going to overthrow God, and he's saying, and I. We have to understand and be mindful of ourselves when we get to actually using I, and I'm taking credit for myself, and I will do it, and I will do it, and I'll build this, and I'll do this. Nowhere does it say that it sought God in any of that imagination, principle. Hallelujah, from that standpoint. So God is saying today for us that principles are released. Yes, they are. The word of God is truth. Yes. But the thing it is God is calling us to come up higher than where we've ever been in our lives, that we can operate in the fullness of the faith. Now faith. When is now? Now is now. Now is now. When you hear it is now. When he said it is now. When he tell you to go and move and do and his now, by faith, the size as a mustard seed, not like a mustard seed, but as faith as a mustard seed. Because as the mustard seed, a likened a mustard seed, is dealing from the point of what's in the seed will manifest. It's the smallest seed, but yet it yields the greatest of the harvest. faith, imagination, moving forward. Hallelujah. See, without faith in God and His Word, we will not connect to God's imagination. You're saying to me that God has an imagination? Yes, I am. We go back to Genesis. He said, let us do these things. Let us. And He did, and it happened, and the manifestation came forward because it had already been seen. When we talk about Alpha and Omega, He see the end, and that is the release. And now we go back to the beginning to move forward. That's the imagination. And God has an imagination. Without faith in God and His Word, we would not connect to God's imagination. God's imagination is the original intent He had for creation according to Genesis 1 and 27. And 1 and 27, you should know it. We all know it, but I'm going to read it. So God created man in His own image. What are we talking about? Imagination, image, imagination. In the image of God created He him. Male and female created He them. When we look at in His image, we're talking about a mirror. If I put a mirror in front of your face, you're going to see yourself. But if I put the mirror in front of your face and you're in the kingdom of God and God is in you and you are in Him and He's sitting on the right hand of the Father, He's making intercession for you and you're in the image of God and you're in Christ Jesus and you are a, not only just a believer, but you're a disciple. I'm going to use that word, disciple. And you're a disciple of Almighty God. And you are discipling the Word, teaching the Word, releasing the Word, living the Word, operating in the principles of the kingdom of God. Then you're operating in the imagination, the image, the mirror of Almighty God. We were created by God, but we were created to be godly creators. We were created by God, but we were created to be godly creators of the kingdom of God. Creators, imagination, image. He's bringing it all around. Faith in the Word, imagination of creativity. In the Word, in God. Hallelujah. Now, when we look at the two words, imagination and vision, you may say, well, in imagination and vision, what about the same? Okay. Are both a word that I'm going to use is called abstract. Imagination and vision, they're abstract. But imagination goes beyond vision. We go to Habakkuk, he says, write the vision, make it plain, that those that come behind can read it, they can understand it, and they can go with it. They can see what you're saying. Can you see what I'm saying with the vision? But imagination goes beyond vision because it pulls the intangible, that's the unseen world, of what you see into creativity. We were created to be godly creators, and we were created to be godly creators through the creativity of the power of the Holy Spirit that He would release in our imagination as we move forward, as we are colliding with faith. Faith in the Word of God. Faith in God. Hallelujah. Imagination of the Word of God in us. The hope of glory, the release that will go forward. While vision is the sense or ability of sight, you see it. I see the vision. See the vision, write it down. See the vision, write it down. Vision is seeing. Imagination is both seeing, which is vision, and creativity, which is the manifestation of what's seen. So in order to move the tangible, the intangible, the unseen realm, into the tangible of what you can teach, what you can touch, see, hear, smell, taste, feel, tangible. It shows up. In order to go into that place, we got to go deeper. We got to go deeper and allow the Word of God to go deeper on the inside of us so that we can operate in those places of creativity according to the imagination that He has placed in us that lines up with the Word of God, that is godly creativity in moving forward. When faith and imagination collides, is what we're talking about today. Now, Proverbs 29 and 18 teaches, and our banner says this, where there is no vision, the people perish. You need the ability to see. This is the year of 2020, right? And prophetically, this has been the year of vision, the year to see. But what we see in the world is things that we have to go into the spirit, because what you see in the world is not what you're seeing in the spirit of Almighty God. Your 2020 vision has to line up with the word of God, has to line up with the faith that you have by faith. I believe by faith you line up. So you're going to have to pull it. And you're going to have to move from world system as we restart, realign, readjust, reboot, recalibrate, all those re's. And we're going to have to move from off of and out of. We are citizens of another land. We have to operate in another place so that we can move into the fullness of Almighty God, what he has for us. We have to be able to see into the kingdom of God, because the world is operating in total chaos. Everything is shaken. Chaos meaning turmoil, mayhem, unevil, unhealed, and instability. And it seems to be an organized thing, right? Some groups are organizing certain things of mayhem, instability, chaos. So we have to move from out of those system of turmoil into the peace and love and joy in the kingdom of Almighty God. But we got to do that by faith. In faith, in the word, in the imagination. Can you see something different from what you see? What are you seeing is the question. What are you seeing? The third part that we're talking about is collides. Remember, the first part was faith. The second was imagination. And the third part is collides. Now, when something collides, it hit with force in movement. It's force. It is a forceful impact. Collision occurs when there is motion. A car accident. Going down the road, everybody had speed. There was motion involved. Collisions can also be very violent. Collision, collide. A force, an impact. Motion, violent. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When faith and imagination collides. So what is going to collide? What's going to be the force? What is going to be the impact? What is the motion, the momentum? You know, say a body at rest, stay at rest. You have to have motion. Motion. And that's a law within itself. So when collides happen, the word of God teaches according to Matthew 11 and 12. And this translation reads, from the days of John the Baptist until now, when is now, the kingdom of heaven has been subject to violence, and the violence lay claim to it. Remember, I just told you about the word collides. It's a force. It's a forceful impact. It's motion and it's violent. Okay. Now, some translation says, as opposed to saying lay claim to it, it says seize it. See, that's a military term. We got to seize some stuff. Not only lay claim on it. When we lay claim to something, that establishes where you move into a new territory. When you move into a new territory in the kingdom of God by faith and the imagination that is being released, when you move into this new territory, you are able to lay claims on it. You lay stakes on it, right? And when you lay stakes on it, you may claim that this belonged to me. I take ownership of it. So we're colliding in the spirit of faith. I take ownership of what I believe in the word of God. When we collide into the imagination, I take ownership of what I see that lines up with the word of God in my motion, in the impact that it will have on my life, in my life, through others. King James used that same scripture and he said he take it by force. Take it by force. And the kingdom of God suffer violence, and the violent take it by force. Lay hands on it. Lay claim, seize it, and take it by force. What everything that belongs to you, that he has released to you by faith, in your faith to believe, in your imagination to see, not only to see, but also to pull it into manifestation and from the intangible realm, the supernatural realm, that will come down to the natural realm, that you can operate in the fullness, that all this collides together and you take ownership. It's yours. It's yours. It's yours, but it's by faith. It's by faith that we believe, that we build up, that we move forward into the things of God, the way of God, what he's released. Oh, yes, you are an overcomer. Yes, you are. The second parallel that I want to present to you today, it comes out of Genesis 30, verses 32 to 33. We're going to look at that. Now, this is dealing with the life of Jacob. And when Jacob was working for Laban, he and go back and read the story from the standpoint of the teaching as it relates to him having Leah and Rebecca. And he loved Rebecca, and he's ready to leave. You know, you should be in a place in your life right now with certain things. You ready to go? Are you standing on that staircase just on the landing page? You're not going any further. You're just there. Even in the websites, they have landing page. You don't go no further. There's nothing else. There's no other contents. You just have a landing page. That's it. That's it. That's it. You just stop right here. But the thing of it is, as you move forward in the kingdom of God, this is your season, your time. This is your moment in history for you, for your family, for your ministry, for your business, to move further, go further, seize it, lay hand, lay claims to it, and take it by force. Genesis 30, 32 to 33, and it reads, "Let me go through all your flocks today," that's like now, "and remove from them every speckled and spotted sheep, every dark colored lamb, and every speckled and spotted goat. They will be my wages," verse 33, "and my honesty will testify for me in the future." That's my word. "Whenever you check on the wages you have paid me, any goat in my possession that is not speckled or spotted, or any lamb that is not dark colored, will be considered stolen." This is what Jacob is now having this conversation with Laban. He's getting ready to go. "I'm ending some things, and I'm going to present to you that all I want is the speckled and spotted goat, and I want the speckled and spotted sheep. I want the lamb and the goat. That's it. They're going to look a certain way. They're going to be dark. They are going to have speckles and spots on them, unlike the regular classification of what a lamb looked like. It's going to surpass supernaturalness in every way. It's going to surpass your imagination." See, that was kind of funny to Laban, because it's like, really? The speckle and spotted one? That don't happen all the time. If you go to certain parts of zoos, they have Jacob's lambs that are there. I went to the fair one time and I saw one. It was over with the animals, and it was in this, you know, corrals place where it was feeding with the hay, grass, whatever it was on the floor. But they call it Jacob's lamb. It was in the place, so it do exist. So he said, "This is what I want, because I'm ready to go. We finna conclude this deal. We finna put an end stop on it. And this is all I want." Laban says, "Oh, yeah, you know, cool. You can have that," because it was considered as a minority, not the majority of his flock. So he's like, "Yeah, I'll give you that. I'll give you the lesser." Well, today the Lord is wanting to give you the greatest of all. He wants to release to you. But you got to operate in faith, by faith. When faith and imagination collide, you got to come on up. Come on up. Let's come on up, all of us. We got to come on up in this restart, reboot, recalibrate, realignment, global change. We're dealing with chaos on so many levels. So moving into a place that you can pull some serenity, peace out of chaos, we're moving to another place, in another place. So that we can live in a new place of faith, by faith, with faith. So what is happening is there's a separation that's about to take place here between Jacob and Laban. He's preparing, process, remember that word? Okay, so he's processing some things. He's moving. There's some things in your spirit that the Lord has already begun to drop in your spirit when you're processing. Some of us are in the places that we're about to move. We're in places that we're going to leave some old places. We're in some places that we're going to leave some old relationships. We're in places that we don't have a job, and we've got to stretch ourselves into the creativity realm that, you know, I cook cakes well, I bake well. I never thought about being sales, but I think I might have to. You're going to have to do something you've never done before. Why? You got to do it in faith. You got to imagine yourself, I can. I am an overcomer. I can. I can do it. I can take, through God, I can take the impossibility realm, and it can shift and change to possible. All things are possible to them that what? Believe. Okay? So as we move forward, let's just go on down a little bit, because we're going to tie in the creativity. Remember, imagination is creativity and how that works. So when you look at Genesis 30, we're still there. Look at verses 37 through 39. And it reads, Jacob, however, took fresh cut branches from poplar, almond, and plane trees and made white stripes on them by peeling the bark and exposing the white inner wood of the branches. Oh, we talking imagination. Verse 38. Then he placed the peeled branches in all the watering troughs so that they would be directly in front of the flocks when they came to drink, when the flocks were in heat and came to drink. Verse 39, they made it in front of the branches, and they bore young that was streaked and speckled and spotted. All of that deals with imagination. He spoke the fact of what will manifest through the power of creation, creativity. You are created in God to be a creator of creativity. So he took from three different trees, and he put it where it was speckled in spots, and he made it. And he put it into the water. Into the water. The water is symbolic of the Holy Spirit. He put these sticks that came from branches that came from these three different trees, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, three, the number. He put it in the water that is symbolic of the Holy Spirit. And he put it where vision will take place. Not only vision, but manifestation. So it took it from vision to see, into operating into a place of imagination, that manifestation showed up. From the intangible, the abstract, the unknown realm, the supernatural realm, the manifestation from heaven in the realm of the spirit that manifests through the birthing and mating of animals that came forth, goats and lambs that were speckled and spotted. Imagination. What is it that you see? Can you see beyond CNN, MSNBC, and Fox? Can you go deeper into the things of God, the ways of God, the truth of God that will manifest to cause you to pull out from the invisible realm into the right here, right now realm? Show up realm, manifestation realm, like being it was. Can you declare and decree what you're seeing and what you're imagining, imagination, godly imagination, beyond your circle, beyond your fraternity, beyond your sorority, beyond your family? Can you allow the Holy Spirit on the core of you to expand you to a point that you say, I want more than what I see, what's around me? Oh, I'm seeing something that is greater than what I am in the midst of. But are you ready to tap into the spirit of Almighty God when faith and imagination collides? You got to have a force. You got to have motion. You got to have movement. You got to make an impact. You got to push in. You got to move beyond the landing that you're standing on that stairwell. You got to move to go from glory to glory to glory so that you can move up and operate in the fullness of Almighty God. God, he has purposed you. He know you. He said, I knew you before you ever conceived in your mother's womb. I know that great is on the inside of you. No matter what it looked like, you're well able. I'm well able. You're well able. Through God, you're well able. Through the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You are an overcomer. When faith and imagination collides. When faith and imagination collide. Hallelujah. If you would, just close your eyes. Just close your eyes. Hallelujah. 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 Father God, in the name of Jesus, oh, you are so worthy to be praised. We thank you for this day. We thank you for what you're doing in our lives, and we have a spirit of yes in our soul. Our mind, our will, and our emotion wants to line up with you. And everything that is out of order and everything that needs to come in the fullness of alignment of who you are and who you created me to be according to the purpose that you've already established for me. Hallelujah. I submit to you right now and say, I need more of you, Lord, my faith to grow. Hallelujah. So that we can move into another place. Glory to God, that we can move and operate from another standing. Glory to God. We believe by faith that when we pray that you're with us, you're here. Holy Spirit, have your way. Hallelujah. Have your way. In that man, that woman, that boy, and that girl, that they can open up and say, I am an overcomer because of Christ, 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 Christ. The finished work of the cross, what you've done for me. By your stripes, I'm healed. Everything, every trauma. Everything that has caused us to stop. Hallelujah. We come against it right now. We pull it down in the Holy Spirit now, now. Peace now. Love now. Joy now. Unforgiveness has to go right now in the name of Jesus so that we can move forward according to your word. We open up ourselves to receive so that we can move up that stairwell from glory to glory to glory. So that we can move into another dimension of you. By faith, by faith, by faith. We are together corporately by faith, believing, trusting, relying, depending, leaning on that everlasting arm. Glory to God. So that we can move and operate into this new place, this new dimension, this new place of glory. Hallelujah. Jesus. So that we can move and operate in this new place of your glory. Release unto us right now, Father. Release unto us the vision. But release unto us the imagination so we can take the vision, write it down, and go forward into the creativity that you've released. The creativity that you've already released. Hallelujah. We pull it down now. We pull it from the supernatural into the natural. We pull it down. Glory to God. We pull it down. We pull it down. Jesus. Hallelujah. Have your way, Holy Spirit. You're so worthy. In a spirit of yes, we say yes. We say yes, 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 yes. We want to be more. We want to go deeper. We want to align with your word. We want to move in the new reset of the kingdom because the boot, the reboot, the boot, the reboot, the realignment, the readjusting, the recalibrating has already occurred. So we turn everything off. We turn it off just as with the cell phone. We turn it off. We turn everything off. Turn it off so that we can hear you, so we can receive. So when we come back up and online, hallelujah, we're operating in the fullness of the new assignment, of the new place, of the new place of glory. Jesus. Thank you, Father, for what you're doing. And we believe by faith that we're two together. You're here. And we thank you for your visitation. We thank you for the presence. Hallelujah. Presence of Almighty God that surpasses all understanding, all reasoning of my own limited mindset. That we can go deeper, go further into you. That we can be in that new dimension of your glory. Jesus. We thank you. We glorify you and we magnify you. We will continue to give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. It is in Jesus' name we pray, we declare and decree that it is so. It is so. It is so when? Now, 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 faith. Now, now. Right now, we believe. In the matchless name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. 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 Elevation, 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 elevation. Come on, elevation. That word has made an impact in your life. Listen to it again. Share it. Listen to it again. Spirit for you. He'll talk to you. He'll tell you. He'll show you all things. All you have to do is believe. I'm Prophetess Kay McCray of Broken Clay Ministry, Phoenix City, Alabama. And I thank you so much for allowing me to come and to minister to you today and give you the words of the Lord. I pray that God continue to bless you in all that you do. Seek him first. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things shall be added unto you. Oh, we will serve a mighty good God, a loving God, a kind God. Oh, yes, we do. Again, I'm Prophetess Kay McCray of Broken Clay Ministry, and there's one thing I want to leave with you today as I go. I want you to have a great day, and have a great day.